हेलो एवरीवन, डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे विल स्टार्ट अवर चैप्टर थर्ड फ्रॉम हिस्ट्री. यू नो बिफोर इट वी स्टडीड चैप्टर नंबर वन ऑफ हिस्ट्री, दैट इज राइज ऑफ नेशनलिज्म इन यूरोप. दैट वी स्टडीड राइज ऑफ नेशनलिज्म इन यूरोपियन कंट्रीज ओनली, बट इन दिस चैप्टर दैट इज नेशनलिज्म इन इंडिया. टुडे वी विल स्टडी नेशनलिज्म इन इंडिया. इट मीन्स इन द रेफरेंस ऑफ इंडिया वी स्टडी हाउ नेशनलिज्म वाज इमर्ज्ड. यू नो इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वी स्टडीड अबाउट what are the icons, what are the symbols of revolutionaries who used to unite the nation, to unite the people having a different common culture, common language and common identity. But they promoted, they encouraged all the revolutionaries, they promoted and encouraged the common identity, common culture, common language and common customs or traditions among the society of European countries. Thereafter, slowly, they inspired the people of European countries to develop the democratic rule by abolishing monarch government or monarch system. Before 18th century, there was monarch system not only in our country, but also all over the world countries. Mostly countries, they were controlled by monarch. There was monarch, autocratic rules we can say. But nowadays, most of the countries of the world, they are republic country. Mostly republic country, it means it is governed by an elected ruler, either the president or prime minister. It means it must be elected by person, by people, directly or indirectly. That is the democratic system. So it was the inspiration was started in the world countries to abolish the system of monarch, and also the system of democratic government would be promoted in all the countries of the world, so that everyone had right to do any activity and to develop the economy of the nation and to live his her life. This is very crucial for everyone. But now we will study nationalism. We will start our topic from nationalism. What is nationalism? You know, so many peoples of any nation, either in our nation or either any other country of Europe, they have different identity. In the term of culture, in the term of language, in the term of clothing, in the term of different common identity. But despite of these varieties, most of the peoples, they are coming together by uniting the people of a nation. It means nowadays, in the modern time, most of the people, after promoting democratic setup, they are going to promote, they are going to set up a democratic permanent government by coming together, having a lot of variation, having a lot of disparities among the society of any nation. Like in our country, we can see so many variation among the society. Different kinds of peoples are living in our country in the term of language, in the term of clothing, culture, language, dialect and religion also. Despite of it, India is a united country. We are united. So this is the identification, this is the result of common identification. ये common identification का result होता है. Just we are coming together despite of disparities among the society. So this is the nationalism. It means nationalism refers the common identity within a geographical boundary of any nation. The people have common identity, common culture. It means one is feeling to promote the nation, to develop the nation. That is the nationalism. But before it, I want to tell you what is the nation. व्हाट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ नेशन, नेशन क्या होता है, नेशन का कॉन्सेप्ट क्या होता है। नेशन रेफर्स द डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पीपल दे आर लिविंग इन ए ज्योग्राफिकल बाउंड्री, इट मीन्स यूनाइटेड पीपल बाय कॉमन हिस्ट्री, कॉमन कल्चर, कॉमन क्लॉथिंग, कॉमन लैंग्वेज एंड दे आर लिविंग टूगेदर इन ए सर्टेन ज्योग्राफिकल बाउंड्री ऑफ द नेशन, दैट इज द नेशन। ओके, सो नेशन एंड नेशनलिज्म, इट मीन्स देयर इज ए लिटिल डिफरेंस बिटवीन टू टर्म, नेशनलिज्म एंड नेशन। नेशन, ओके, सो आई होप दैट इट इज वेरी क्लियर व्हाट इज द नेशन एंड व्हाट इज नेशनलिज्म। नेशनलिज्म रेफर्स अ कॉमन आइडेंटिफिकेशन अमंग द सोसाइटी ऑफ नेशन, दैट इज द नेशनलिज्म। बट नेशन, नेशन रेफर ए लार्ज बॉडी ऑफ यूनाइटेड पीपल, नेशन रेफर्स अ लार्ज बॉडी ऑफ यूनाइटेड पीपल इन विच दे आर लिविंग बाई कमिंग टूगेदर, दैट इज द नेशन। वी विल स्टडी नेक्स्ट टर्म, दैट इज इंस्पायरेशन ऑफ नेशनलिज्म। बिफोर इट आई वॉन्ट टू इंट्रोड्यूस अबाउट द इंस्पायरेशन ऑफ नेशनलिज्म, यू नो इन फर्स्ट चैप्टर राइज ऑफ नेशनलिज्म इन यूरोप वी स्टडीड अबाउट द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन, ऑल्सो वी स्टडीड अबाउट द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन इन नाइन्थ स्टैंडर्ड हिस्ट्री, वेरी बिग रेवोल्यूशन, टर्निंग पॉइंट ऑफ द डेमोक्रेटिक सेटअप फ्रॉम द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन, इट वॉज अकर्ड इन 1789 में जब फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन हुई थी, इट वॉज नॉन टर्निंग पॉइंट इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ यूरोपियन कंट्रीज फ्रॉम फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन। फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन वाई इट वॉज अकर्ड, ये क्यों हुई थी, मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ यूरोपियन कंट्रीज जस्ट देवर विलिंग टू डेमोक्रेटिक सेटअप, जस्ट देवर गोइंग टू सेट अप डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट बाय कॉलेप्सिंग, बाय एब्लॉइशिंग द मोनार्क सिस्टम। मोस्ट ऑफ द कॉमन पीपल्स ऑफ द मिडिल क्लास पीपल देवर willing to change, it means they wanted to develop themselves, they want to develop themselves from monarch system to democratic system, they were willing to get rights, fundamental rights of human, it means it was possible only the installment of democratic system. So it was the French Revolution. French Revolution inspired all the people of European countries to set up democratic government. Likewise, in our country, also it was the age in modern time by inspirable from the French Revolution, all the community of India, we were willing to remove colonial government. It was the British government in our country. But beginning of 20th century, it was very active period to remove the colonial government because of in 1915 Mahatma Gandhi came back in our country India. Thereafter he started so many revolutions, so many movements by coming together all the different communities of India, and first they started in 1920 non-cooperation movement. Non-cooperation movement. Also, it was the period is known in our country the starting of movement to promote democratic government. This is the time of 1920 non-cooperation movement was started by Gandhiji to come together all the societies or community of India. And in what respect the growth of nationalism in India was started, how many peoples just they are willing to promote democratic setup, people they were willing to get fundamental rights or human rights, it was known also the launching or starting of non-cooperation movement. So most of the Indians just they were thinking about how to promote the democratic setup and also how, in what respect we can get our rights, hum apne rights kaise le sakte hain. So all the people people having a different community, caste, religion, culture, language, dialect, clothing. Despite of it, all the communities became and came together. ये सब लोग इकट्ठे हो गए थे. After that we will study the First World War. First World War also after completion, after finishing First World War, most of the people of India, they became very angered with British East India Company or colonial government. Because of at the time of First World War, most of the people, they were thinking after end of First World War, we would be free from colonial government and we will create, we will develop our own government. हम अपनी government, निजी government को elect करेंगे. So it was the period of 1914 to 1918, the period of First World War. After ending of First World War, most of the hopes of Indians was not completed by British government. In this regard, most of the societies of India and the citizens of India became very angered. Thereafter, they participated the movement. It was started by Mahatma Gandhi, Non-Cooperation Movement in 1920. Very bad impacts could be seen after ending First World War, like increase of tax. These are the bad impact result of First World War. Because of most of the economy, it was consumed in the expenditure of First World War. So it led to the rising prices. Also, second problem, rising prices. These were the main issues before the Indian, and one more, that was the food shortage. Food shortage. Why food shortage? It means most of the people, they were busy to support in the First World War. And number four, forced recruitment. It means जबरदस्ती लोगों को soldier बनाया जाता था to fight against other enemies in World War. Most of the people in our country, just they were forced to recruit in army of British, so that they can support from my side. So most of the Indians, they were angered due to these reasons, because of the increase of tax, rising prices, food shortage, forced recruitment. These were the main issues before the Indian peoples. Also, these problems inspired the people of India, and they started movement. It was the non-cooperation movement. Okay, student. Next period, we will study further. Okay, thank you.